Did you know that Egyptians use arsenic to treat skin cancer, Greeks and Romans used a mixture of pumice and tree resins to exfoliate skin, and Turkish treatments even included fire? It's crazy how much technology has advanced to impact the dermatologic field and affect Americans everywhere. Let's talk to local dermatologist Dr. Fulchero to see how technology impacts his everyday life.
Hi, I'm Dr. Greg Fulchero from Keystone Dermatology and Center for Skin Surgery in Altoona, Pennsylvania. I am a board-certified dermatologist and fellowship-trained skin cancer and reconstructive surgeon. My undergraduate training was at Cornell University College of Engineering, and then I went to medical school at the Temple University School of Medicine in Philadelphia, PA. When treating patients with skin cancer, there's a number of different technologies that are involved. Some of the technology involves the processing of the tissue, such as this cryostat here, which allows us to rapidly freeze and process the tissue so that we can look at it under a microscope. Other technology, such as the microscope, involves optics and other forms of physics. Still other types of technology includes material science and material science engineering, such as the bioengineered skin grafts, suture materials, and other products that we'll use to reconstruct the defects after the skin cancer has been removed. Even further, we'll use temperature-based cryosurgery to freeze tumors down to minus 50 degrees centigrade, which will kill the cancer cells if other forms of surgery are not an option. Additionally, some patients aren't surgical candidates at all, and we will refer them to have radiation oncology or radiotherapy, in which high forms of photons, electrons, or neutrons are used to kill the cancer cells and prevent them from dividing. Oftentimes, the cancer cells are arrested at certain phases of mitosis that prevent the cancer from growing and killing the patient or the surrounding tissues. This device is a stainer that's used to stain the tissue and help us identify under the microscope cancer cells from normal tissue. The different staining and the patterns of the cancer cells help us differentiate what is normal tissue and what is cancer. This can be done in a couple different ways, with different types of dyes and sometimes even a different antibody. An antibody is something that will link up to an antigen, which might be a pigment cell of the skin cancer, that can then be highlighted so it's much easier to see, almost like a fluorescent glow stick. One of the tools that we'll use to fight skin cancer and other skin conditions is temperature, such as liquid nitrogen, which is approximately minus 170 degrees. Liquid nitrogen, which is truly a liquid that is then expelled onto the tissue, freezes tissue, and at minus 25 degrees can prevent skin cells from forming pigment by killing the process of melanin formation, so we can take a dark spot and make it lighter. At minus 50 degrees, it can actually kill the skin cells through the process of frostbite. This simple device, which is very similar to a fire extinguisher, can be used for everything from benign processes such as a wart to malignant processes such as a superficial skin cancer. The recent advent in genetic testing is allowing us to get more and more precise and less invasive. This recent kit called DermTech is state of the art. It looks for genetic signatures within the skin cells using a sticker to remove some of the skin cells and looking at the DNA. And it gives us a percentage or likelihood that a lesion would be cancerous or not cancerous. So without removing the skin, without cutting the skin of a patient, we're able to use this skin biopsy kit and actually apply a sticker to the patient four different times, remove some of those skin cells above the pigmented lesion, and that gets sent for analysis, in which they'll give us a likelihood, meaning likely or unlikely, that a particular lesion would be cancer or melanoma without actually having to remove the skin.